Ang guest natin ngayon ay isang napakahusay na host, writer, content creator, wife, and mom to two young girls, Miss Bianca Gonzalez. I know you have been having your podcast for quite some time already. Ako bago pa lang. So, I'm very happy that you will be my first ever guest. So, maraming salamat sa iyo.
Of course. First of all, thank you, ma'am, for having me. When I found out na buena mano guest, I was so kidding. But also, congratulations. Welcome to the podcasting world.
Alam mo, Bianca, for so long, so many people have been asking me to do a podcast of my own. Lalo dito sa office, because a lot of our staff are very young people. And sinasabi nila, para naman makausap mo yung mga age group namin. Pero ninenervyos ako kasi sabi ko baka hindi ko kayanin. Pero I have a radio program of my own. And sabi nila, hindi naman siya masyadong maiiba. And then I got invited a few months ago to a few podcasts. And surprisingly, I enjoy them. So, sabi ko, sige, subukan na natin. So, eto.
Yes, I love it. Okay. So, for everyone listening, the title of your podcast is...
The Leni Robredo Podcast. Actually, Bianca, we've had a lot of discussions on what the title will be. Hanggang hindi kami nagkakasundo. And finally, sinabi nila, sige na nga, The Leni Robredo Podcast na lang para wala nang debate. I'm actually excited. I'm excited because yung experience ko sa aking radio program, you know, you get to talk to many different people who sometimes do not share your experiences. I learn a lot from my radio program. So, lalo na dito. Kasi, syempre, limited din yung reach na aking radio program. Hopefully, with this podcast, I will be able to reach the generation of my daughters.
Oh, I love it. And actually, I think, because me, ma'am, I am a big podcast listener talaga. I'm looking forward to hearing you from you, not from an article written about you or what other people said about you, what you like, who you are, from you mismo. I have a last question, ma'am, before we get into our topic.
Yes.
So, for the Leni Robredo podcast, what can we expect? What kind of guests would you like to invite, or what kind of topics do you want to talk about?
More casual, as I have said, more intimate. Yung first line of guests that we are looking at are, yung tingin ko, I have some similarities too. Halimbawa, you. Halimbawa, you're very young. You're almost, and then, halimbawa, you're almost my daughter, diba? Pero nabasa ko, I follow your blog before. Yung diba, my blog, ikaw dati. I don't know if I was in politics already, pero I read your blogs, and kinakwento mo before you were shy. Diba, kinakwento mo yun? You're actually very shy before. You're private. At tapos parang, you talk a lot about your family, your brother, your older sister. So, alam ko yon. Alam ko
yon. I can't believe this. Yes. Pinapawisan ako.
For example, yung pagiging shy. When I was still in school, I was so shy. In fact, that was the frustration of my mom. Na, alam mo yon, I was very active in school, pero I wanted to do the back-end work. Halimbawa, I was into theater arts. Pero ako yung sa script, ako yung sa curtain, ako yung lights, ayoko yung bida. Yung younger sister ko was less shy, so she would get the yung mga bida parts. And yung mom ko was into ballet and everything, so ako yung frustration niya na I didn't want to participate in a lot of things that would, alam mo yon, that would parang force me to face an audience.
Mm-mm.
So yung mga declamation contests, mga things like that, ayoko yon. So parang sa amin, I was the least likely to enter politics. Much more campaign for myself. I never joined the student council. Ano yung turning point mo? Ano yung turning point? I know you took up comms, mm-hmm. diba, in college. You went to Ateneo.
Wait, this
you
is so
comms.
Surreal that you know all this information yes, about because me. Parang nalaloka ako. Okay, yes.
Kasi nga binabasa ko yung, binabasa ko yung blogs mo before.
I really wanted to become a filmmaker. Gusto ko po sana magsulat, mag-direct, which is why I took communication arts. Very shy, but when I was first year college, I remember I was walking in the mall with my sister, and like you, my sister is the really model-esque type, carries herself well, you know, talagang mas confident, mas extroverted, I'm the more introverted one. Nung time na yon, uso pa yung mga model search, tapos may kiosk sa mall. Yes. So we were approached by someone in that kiosk. Gusto niyo ba to try out in the search? And again, it's my sister who's really the confident model type. So akala ko siya. And then sinabi nila, sama ka na rin.
Okay.
And to cut the long story short, it ended up that I got the role.
Oh my God. Okay.
So when I did the commercial, it was a shampoo commercial. Parang na-enjoy ko siya. And even if I was shy, I enjoyed working with everyone on set. Kasi nga, I liked the workings of production also. And somehow, I guess I found this, which I still have until now, huh? This on button.
Okay.
Like, I'm very, very shy. But when I know, kunyak, I have to go on stage na, I psych myself and I turn on that button. And then, yun na, parang I'm performance mode, host mode. Oh. Parang ganyan.
Talagang yung politics was really not in my horizon. It only happened because the man I married eventually became a politician. Na no choice ako in the sense na it was not my cup of tea. But I wanted to support him every step of the way. So pero ako nasa background ako. Ako yung taga-ayos ng alam mo yon, during elections, I would be the one to take care of the headquarters. Siyempre, along the way, you would talk to barangay captains, to his political leaders. Pero that was it. Pero when he died, parang when the plane crash happened, parang all of a sudden, I found myself in his shoes. So parang na no choice ako. No choice ako in the sense na I had to step up. Pero nung nag-step up ako, parang para sa akin, utang ko sa kanya na hindi ko noon masira yung pangalan niya. So I knew that I had to parang take the work seriously even if it was not something that I wanted to do in the first place. Kailangan kong husayan kasi nakakahiya sa pangalan na pinagpaguran niya. So sa akin ganon. Pero yung sayo, you were thrust into this. Pero it was not as if you were left with no choice, di ba? Parang yung sa akin kasi na no choice ako. Pero even if that was the case, parang sobrang husay mo. Ang gusto ko sabihin, when you are serious about something that you do, it shows eh. Parang people feel it. Yeah. They did not cause you any anxiety na if you will not follow the usual formula, baka you will not stay long in the business or you will not be as successful as you are now? Wala bang ganun na fear sa'yo?
100% that fear. And my favor is after I answer this question, I have a question for you related to that question. Yes, super. Especially at the very, very start of my career. And people don't know this. Not a lot of people know this. Kasi I am now a host for Pinoy Big Brother. Yes. But I started as a housemate.
Yes.
Ginawa akong housemate.
Pinanood kita.
Ay, oh my God. Oh, those days. Okay. Ginawa akong housemate because they wanted a host that experienced what it was like to be a housemate. So I didn't know that when they made me a housemate. Mm-mm. Akala ko housemate na ako. And so after, naturally, do you want to do like a teleserye, a movie? Do you want to audition for this role? Ganyan. And even then, I was already very clear with my manager, who's still my manager now, Tito Boy Abunda. Mm-hmm. I said, Tito Boy, I really just want to host. And he told me, mm-hmm. I remember this so clearly. Sabi niya, Bianca, there aren't as much jobs for hosts. And hosts don't really earn as much as like if you do a movie or a soap. Are you sure? And I said, yes, this is just what I want to do and try out and go kumbaga, try to master as much as I can. And I think what's so important also is that support system, because I knew of other managers or other artists who felt pressured by their managers or their networks na sige, they'll do everything.
Pero siguro, Bianca, importante yung sinabi mo eh. When you know what you want, diba, you become so sure of how you want to do it. Gusto ko lang yung i-emphasize for our listeners, especially the younger people who are listening to us, na it's okay. It's okay not to follow the playbook.
Yeah.
It's okay to chart your own course. Kasi ano naman eh, 'di ba?
Yes.
Parang you don't have to parang allow yourself to be pressured into doing things that you're not comfortable with or you're not sure na doon ka talaga papunta.
I do have a question, ma'am. Like I said
yes,
earlier.
Yes, sige.
In my case kasi the consequences of like forging my own path would just be paid by me. Like,
yes.
Meaning, ako lang yung mananagot for whatever choice I make. But in your case, it's different because you serve people. Or, for example, when you're a congresswoman, you serve your constituents. So, your choice of forging your path, hindi lang ikaw yung na-affect.
Totoo.
So, how?
ako again, Bianca, parang ako, I don't credit it all to myself. Kasi again, I saw how my husband did it. So para sa akin, meron na akong model. Pero just to give you an example. After my husband died, he died August of 2012. Yung October was already filing. And you know, last day of filing then, 2 months. Wala akong plano. When he died, parang yung party nila, local party nila in Naga, had candidates already. Na parang they talked about it already even before the plane crash. So, it was all there. Pero when he died, nag-away-away. Ang sasabihin, meron na mga ayaw sundin, yung mga napag-usapan. And, you know, they were seeking my counsel. And I was trying to help patch things up. Pero yung last day of filing, I remember it so well, October 5, may hindi nagkasundo. And ang naging result, and they didn't even consult me. Nag-announce sila na ako na yung kandidato. So alam mo yon na it was so difficult for me, for the children. Grabe yung iyakan ng mga anak ko. And kandidato na ako. In other words, pumayag ako last minute, nag-file ako 4 o'clock in the afternoon sa COMELEC last day. So the following day, kandidato na ako. Alam ko kung anong wala ko. Wala akong pera. Wala akong malaking party. Although yung asawa ko had parang alliances with other parties, yung local, ang kalaban namin, malalaking dynasties eh. So I had nothing. Yung distrito ko was one city and 7 towns. Ang kakampi ko lang yung mayor ng isang city.
Wow.
So, yung 7 towns, hindi ko kakampi. Naalala ko, 186 barangays yung district namin. Ang kakampi ko lang, 25. So, alam mo yon, I didn't have money, I didn't have political strength. Pero nakita ko kasi sa asawa ko na kahit wala yon, sipag dala. So ako, dun ako. Alam mo, not a single rally. I did not have a single rally kasi wala akong pang-arkila ng sound system. Ang sound system nun, yung arkila, 7,000. Meron akong konti, sinasabi ko, pambayad ko na to ng watchers. So yung sa akin, mahirap siya in the sense na sarili kong kakampi, pinaparinggan ako, na hindi yan pwede dito sa amin, kailangan maglabas ka ng pera. Eh, wala naman ako ilalabas. It was difficult, pero I won by a landslide. And I think yung winning ko was my capital. It became my political capital. Kasi parang in a way, I was able to show them that you don't need money to win an elections. So parang nung umupo na ako, it was easier. It was easier in the sense na parang merong, I didn't say it, pero parang merong I told you so. Diba? Parang, di ba? hindi, wala kasi kayong tiwala sa akin, kaya. So nung ano na, nung nasa Congress na ako, parang I had a political capital to say na we won't do this, even if this is what all the others are doing, we won't do this kasi napakita ko na sa inyo eh na pwede naman. But that is an aside, kasi when I ran for the vice presidency, again, it was accidental. Parang yung modeling mo din, Bianca, parang you didn't plan it. Pero parang yung sa akin, it was a party thing. Ang gusto kong sabihin, our party was eyeing another vice presidential candidate. And last minute, hindi, parang the talks didn't progress well. So they were left with no vice presidential candidate and they started looking at me. So yung sa akin, parang yung pagkandidato ko una as VP, parang ayoko lang na mapapahiya yung party kasi hindi ako nag-cooperate. Pero nung kandidato na ako, parang yung ugali, I think Bianca, dito tayo nagkakapareho, na kahit ayaw mo, pero dahil nag-decide kang gagawin mo, pagbutihin mo na. Parang, so when I was a candidate already, VP candidate na ako, sobrang sipag ko. And I think one news agency after the elections tracked our yung movement during the campaign. And I was the one national candidate who went to the most number of towns and cities. Ganun ako kadesidido. Halimbawa, mag-i-end yung aming schedule at 9 o'clock, hindi pa ako antok, may pupuntahan pa ako. Parang alam mo yun, sumasideline pa. Ah, kasi desidido ako manalo. Desidido ako manalo kasi pinasok ko na to eh. That's when I won, I was, alam mo naman siguro, all the challenges that I faced. Pero ang sa akin lang, Bianca, parate lang na ginusto ko to, pagbubutihin ko. So I think parang on the past 5 years I did my all.